Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, this is the World of Wayne, and I hope you're having an absolutely brilliant weekend. Now, as I teased on Thursday's livestream, I now have the next three ships of the Fanhome release of the Star Wars Starships and Vehicles collection. Now, all of these figurines are officially licensed from Disney and Lucasfilm, and they feature starships and vehicles from the whole saga, including the spin-off series like The Mandalorian. Now, miniatures are made in die-cast, they're all hand-painted, and some of them do go up to about 15 centimeters in size, almost the size of your face. And all vehicles and spaceships are made with a high-quality finish and feature a custom base with the model name that it's actually displaying. Now, I'm going to do it slightly different today. Rather than have a montage of it in a photo booth, I thought we'll open each individual one and we'll have a look on all three cameras so we can see the detail of what we've got. Now, if you want to get this for yourself, I have put the link down here to the Fanhome website. You can actually get this all the way from pack one. So far, we've already had things like Poe Dameron's X-Wing, we've had the Millennium Falcon, we've had Darth Vader's TIE Fighter. Check out the past videos. There is a playlist and I put it just up there. But we're going to be starting with stage five, issue five, which is the Snowspeeder. Now, obviously, this was made famous by one of the greatest Star Wars films of them all, The Empire Strikes Back. And this is what the magazine looks like. I'm just going to flick through that. Gives you the specifications. Whatever ship that we're actually looking at will always have the specifications in this magazine here. And that is the X-Wing's pilot uniform. Looking cool. And that is the magazine. You do get a magazine with every ship. So this is what the Snowspeeder looks like. Just show you on that camera there. I haven't actually opened this yet. So what I'm going to do, slice this up here and here. And let's have a look what we got. Are you ready for this? There you go. Now, once again, we have got the bracket for the stand there. And the stand looks like this, and it does tell you the name of what the actual model is on here. And quite simply, the stand is just going to go in this way. So the center of gravity, which I didn't do in the first video, is in the center there. That's very important. But let's look at the model. There you go. Now remember, all of these are die-cast. So this whole thing is metal down. I'm just showing you on the close-up camera. Pretty impressive. You've got the harpoon at the back there. I don't know if you can see inside the cockpit there, all the details in there. That's a nice close-up, isn't it? I think I'll keep it on this close-up camera. And then from the underside, that's what that's looking like. And then all we're going to do is we have this facing this way towards where it's written at the front. This just plugs into that like that. And that is what that's looking like. I absolutely love this. Now, if you want to know size-wise, I don't know if it gives it away from my with my hand, but you're looking about 13 centimeters wide by roughly 15 centimeters hand size in length there. But that's what that looks like on my main camera. There you go. Gave you an idea of that. I do love these ships. These are a lot bigger than some of the ships that I've seen in the past. Absolutely ginormous these are. So that is the Empire Strikes Back Snowspeeder. Let's show you what's in number six. This was actually one of my favourite ships of the saga, to be honest with you, and pretty weird really, because it's actually an Empire Imperial Shuttle. So obviously, I think we saw this for the first time in Return of the Jedi. I might be wrong. I don't know if we did see it in Empire Strikes Back. We may have. Can't remember, but I know that the Emperor arrives on this, so and we did see it landing on Endor as well. But this is the magazine looking like that. Let's show you this ship. Now this time it's an absolutely massive box. Check that out. Let's get this out. So once again, this is the stand, just saying the Imperial Shuttle. I'll get this all ready to go here. And I will bring out the Imperial Shuttle. Now, this is, again, a massive ship. Check that out. That's what it's looking like on the top camera. Again, it's all metal. It's not resin or anything like that. This is, probably hear that. But that is what it's looking like on the close-up. Brilliant model. I do love this ship. This is iconic for me from the just before they blow up the tower in Endor. But and that's the underside there. And again, roughly about the size of my hand, as you can see there. Check that out. So let's put this on this stand. Nice little collection, this delivery, I have to say. Some cool ships. And there we go. That's that on the stand. So I'm going to put that to one side. So I've got two together now. But in this pack, we get three. So what is the third one? I can answer that for you now. And it isn't just covering the original Star Wars films. We have got the Razor Crest from The Mandalorian. Obviously, this ship was blown up. But this is what it looks like when it wasn't blown up, when it was all in one piece. And that looks like that here. A little bit about the Mandalorian and the Grogu there. Grogu made this series, I have to say. I love the Mandalorian series. Looking like that. Not too fond of the Boba Fett series, I have to say. But then again, the Boba Fett series was just the Mandalorian like 2.5. But that is the magazine for number 7, the Razor Crest. Let me show you what that looks like. There you go. All in there. Show you on the close-up camera again. Let's get this out. Once again, we've got the plinth there. And we have got the stand for this to go in. Put that on. And let's show you the ship. Now remember, this is fully die-cast, which looks just like that. Look at the shine on that. And the underside. And again, I'm going to show you on the close-up camera. That is the Razor Crest. Pretty impressive ship, huh? Quite heavy as well. Underside and the top side. Once again, as you can probably hear, completely metal. And again, it's a nice big ship, that one. Absolutely love it. What a load we've had in this pack. So let me put this on the stand. And these are the three ships that we have received in this pack. They are absolutely brilliant. It's the size. I love the size of them. The advantage of having a size like this means that you can see actually all the fine details, all the panel work and stuff on each individual ship. Brilliant collection. What do you think? Now, so far, I've got a glass display case that I'm displaying these in. I think these three are just about to fill up the top rack. I'm going to have to start working my way down. But having it all completely full, I think it's going to look pretty impressive. I've got no idea what the next ships are going to be. But as soon as they're here, I will make sure I update the channel so you can see what I'm actually collecting. But if you're a fan of Star Wars and you want to get these for yourself, once again, I have put the link to the Fanhome website down here. You can get this all the way from pack one, starting with the Millennium Falcon. But I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.